Okay, dueling tools. Primarily used to adjust end shakes or replace duels. But they can do more than that. Reaming, pallet stuff adjusting, guard pin adjusting, and more. We'll have a look at everything in this video. Almost everything. I have the Seitz / Bergeon tool. Not the latest redesigned one, but it's a recent one. And I also have the genuine Horia tool. Firstly, I'll show you the tools in detail, how they function, how they differ in quality, and then we'll also look at how each one of them performs, what it can do, and how they compare. They are not cheap tools, so we'll also have a look at the pricing and how I got mine cheaper than you can get from any horological supplier that I know of as of early 2024. That's the Horia tool in a Bergeon box. That's because Bergeon is a reseller. That's all it is. It is the genuine Horia tool. Instead of the lever, this one is threaded. You simply move the spindle up or down by rotating the micrometer. Unlike the Bergeon tool, the Horia tool you buy the pushers and anvil separately. There are different sets you can choose from, or you can get the individual pushers and anvils as you need them. The crucial thing for both tools, the pushers and the anvils have to be perfectly perpendicular. If they are not, you'd run into all sorts of problems. To adjust how far you're going to push with the Bergeon tool, you rotate the micrometer to the desired position. Each division on the micrometer is 1/100th of a millimeter. And this screw is to secure it in place to stop it from rotating accidentally. Once you've got it set, you push the lever and it will come to a stop where you set the micrometer. And we also have the post on the other side, so it doesn't matter if you're left-handed or right-handed. The first thing you noticed with the Horia tool, it's incredibly smooth. It's buttery smooth. And you get the micrometer markers on both sides like the Bergeon, but you also get one on the front of the tool. Now here, each division is 2/100ths of a millimeter. However, if you prefer, you can get the same tool with a finer thread where each division is 1/100th of a millimeter. So instead of 15 turns to get from the top to the bottom, it will be 30 turns. To stop the spindle from rotating, there is a groove in the spindle and this screw that goes through the body of the tool stops it from rotating. The Horia tool is the same, the groove is in the front of the tool and you don't need the screw to guide the spindle, it's going to be done internally. The bases of the tools, we have a hole going through the base. When you push a tool out, it will fall through the anvil, through the hole, you lift the tool and the tool will be on your bench mat. With the Bergeon tool, which is this one, you also get a threaded plug for the hole. This allows you to use any of the pushers as anvils if you wanted to do that. The Horia tool, there is a hole just like in the Bergeon tool, but there is no plug. Interestingly, it does have a thread in the bottom half of the hole. Why the thread is there, I don't know. Here we have all the bits we get with the Bergeon set. They are not just pushers and anvils, you get bits for reducing holes, tightening cannon pinions, etc. We'll get to see them all in detail throughout the video. What you also get is a spindle for the reamers, which is hidden away in the base. If you lose or damage any of the bits, you can buy them separately, so no big deal, but I don't think you can buy different sized pushers and anvils than what you get in this set. The Horia set, this is the set of 24 pushers and anvils, it's purely for replacing or adjusting jewels. There are no other bits in this set. If you damage one, you can buy a replacement, and unlike the Bergeon set, there are other sizes too that are not in this set. Not only that, you can tell Horia specific dimensions you require and they will make it for you, and it's not expensive. Have a look at their website. What I also have is the Horia set of pushers and anvils for Incabloc. You get 6 pushers and 7 anvils, and the empty holes in the base, they are actually very useful. I was able to fit there the pallet staff anvil and pusher, the guard pin anvil and pusher, and also 2 considerably larger anvils than what you get in the set of 24. The Incabloc set is very handy. You need one because you can use it in places where you wouldn't be able to use the standard anvils. This is a train bridge for a Rolex 3035 and you need to push the whole setting, not just the jewel, it's one piece. Now, see how close the milled-out section here is to the setting? You'd struggle to find an anvil that would fit there. The Bergeon set, we only get 3 anvils. And it's not this one, the hole is too small, so it would have to be this one. The Horia anvils, the 1.9 anvil has a hole that would be right for the setting, but look at the advantage of the thin wall of the Incabloc anvil. So if we try the Bergeon, we have no chance, we can't use the anvil. If we try the standard 1.9 Horia, maybe, I wouldn't be comfortable. The Incabloc, no problem at all. It's a great set. You might never use it for Incabloc, but you'd use it for many jobs that the standard anvils wouldn't do. You don't have to use the Incabloc pushers, just the anvil and a pusher of your choice. Now let's have a closer look at the anvils. With the Bergeon set, you only get three of them, which in my opinion is not enough. They look good when you see them like this, but when you get closer, you will suddenly see the imperfections. And this one, well, not just this one, all three, the edges were rough. Both edges, inner and outer. That's what they looked like when I got them. I didn't notice until I used it and saw it mark the main plate I was working on. See those marks here? I was lucky it was just a fun project and not someone else's watch. I ended up tidying up the anvils. You wouldn't expect that, would you? Not for the amount of money these tools cost. It's a little flaky, but at least it's not scratching plates anymore. The Horia anvils, night and day difference. Look at this beauty. It's perfection. It's absolutely flawless. I can't help myself and not play with the light. It's like black polish. Every single one of them, all 24, flawless, made to perfection. That's what you need when you work on watches. You don't want to worry that you might scratch some plates. You don't want to be tidying up the anvils. This is what the Bergeon anvils should be. Now let's have a look at the pushers. This is a Bergeon pump pusher, and the side shake of the centering pin is very acceptable. But if you look at this pump pusher, the side shake is excessive. I don't like it at all. Here we have a Bergeon concave pusher. See this? How it's been finished? That's absolutely insane. You tell me what's going to happen if that's going to push on a concave jewel. Now I want you to pay attention to the side here, how it's rounded, and also the size of the inner concave section here. Here we have another concave pusher. See the inconsistency between these two? The inner convex, it's very minimalistic. Here we have a simple flat pusher. I've never used it, but it looks like it would need tidying up just like the anvil I showed you before. The Horia pushers, again, a whole different story. You get much nicer pushers. You get concave pump pushers. In my opinion, that's all you need. You can always select a larger pusher if you want to get a jewel flush with a plate, and if the centering pin is in the way for whatever reason, you can always take it out for that job. I'll explain shortly why the concave is important. Just like the anvils, the pushers are flawless. Nicely polished, the centering pins, I don't even have to move them around, you can see the tight tolerance. It goes without saying that the Horia pushers are far more superior to the Bergeon pushers. Now, why are the concave pushers important? Let's have a look at this old Seitz brochure I have here. It's quite useful and I will occasionally refer to different sections throughout the video. In short, you need concave pushers for concave jewels. If you look here, you'll see how the pusher conforms to the concave jewel. The curvature of the pusher matches the curvature of the jewel. That doesn't happen. The concave pushers don't look like that. They look like this. These examples are Bergeon concave pushers. These are Horia pushers. They have a nicer, larger and consistent convex. The way it will work for both Horia and Bergeon, the pressure will be here, rather than here as it is shown in this drawing. But that's fine. The problem would arise if you didn't have a concave pusher because you'd be applying pressure on the top of the jewel and you could break it. Now the Chinese Horia clones. I don't own one, but I have seen images and videos, and from what I have seen, they have the centering pin, but they are not convex. If they are not convex, they are not designed for concave jewels. The way around it would be to push the jewel in or out from the flat side of the jewel. If you needed to reduce the end shake, you wouldn't be able to push on the concave side of the jewel. You'd have to push the jewel out and then push it back in from the flat side, but not pushing it as far as it was pushed in before. With the convex pushers, you don't have that issue. You can push from either side of the jewel. With the Bergeon tool, we also get two pallet staff pushers and anvil. The anvil doesn't look impressive. It will need tidying up. But the pushers look fine. That's just a bit of dirt there. It's fine. Horia also makes pallet staff pusher and anvil, which you buy separately. And as you'd expect from Horia, the anvil and the pusher are both made to perfection. The Bergeon tool also comes with pushers for reducing holes in plates. They are all fine, no issues at all. With Bergeon we also get pushers for reducing the diameter of hourhand pipes. They call it hourhand holes, but to me it's a pipe or a tube. It's not a hole as such. And just like the ones for reducing holes, no issues whatsoever. And we also get a pusher and a stake for tightening loose cannon pinions from Bergeon. These two, they look rough. I think it would do the job, but if I'm going to use it, I'll tidy it up. The Horia and Incabloc set is excellent. Anvils and the pushers. The guard pin pusher and anvil from Horia, the footage speaks for itself. It's a feast for the eyes. With Bergeon, we also get reamers. They are very useful. I have to admit, since I bought the Horia tool, I now use the Bergeon tool only as a reamer. Yeah, it turned into a very expensive reamer. Unlike the Bergeon, the Horia tool can't be converted into a reamer. However, Horia also makes a lever style jeweling tool, which I don't have so I can't show you, but it can be used as a reamer. Now if you own the Bergeon tool, you probably experienced the lack of anvils and you might want to know whether the Horia anvils fit the Bergeon tool. The answer is yes they do. I'm not sure why you'd want to fit the Bergeon anvils into the Horia tool, but you could do it. Fitting the Horia pushers into the Bergeon spindle, in my case, I could probably force them in, but I think I'd struggle getting them out. I can't fit the Bergeon pushers into the Horia tool, I have no need for that, but you could do it. I measured the Bergeon pushers at 3.98mm and the Horia pushers at 3.99mm. So it's only 0.01mm difference, but it does make a difference. Pump pushers, they can be easily disassembled and assembled. Both Horia and Bergeon work on the same principle. The dimensions are slightly different, but they are the same thing. Except that the Bergeon, the side check of the pin in the pushers varies from pusher to pusher, while the Horia side check is very minimal and it's consistent amongst all the pushers. What I do like about the Bergeon, every single pusher is stamped with the size. There is nothing on the Horia pushers. And a small tip, you can get a removing tool for the pushers and reamers. 4mm in black, 3mm in white. I bought it from Cousins. The irony is, I found it amongst Horia pushers, anvils, etc. and I needed it for the Bergeon pushers several times, but I never needed it for the Horia pushers. Time to see some action. I'll start with the Horia tool and I'll remove and then insert this little jewel here. You'll see it in the automatic bridge on a 6R15. It is small, it's just there. I'll need the smallest 0.7 pusher and the anvil I'll be using, I'll go two sizes up. If you use the corresponding anvil, the jewel is going to get stuck. First time I tried, it got stuck. Ever since I've been going two more sizes up with the anvils. Now we can start slowly turning. That's it, as simple as that. And here's our jewel. Now let's put it back in. Slowly turn in the micrometer until it's where it should be. There we go. The end shake would have to be tested and possible adjustments made. Now what happens if you use a larger anvil? This is probably what you'll only get to see on camera and you speed up the footage. The plate will flex because of the larger hole and the jewel will suddenly give and pop out. Completely different action to what you've seen before. It will also flex when you push the jewel in and of course the thickness of the plate will play a role, but it's worth noting. Now let's have a look at the Bergeon tool, how we can adjust end shakes and push jewels out. We'll do the center jewel here. You have to find the right size pusher. It needs to be a little smaller than the jewel. If it's larger than the jewel, you're going to push against the plate. If it's considerably smaller than the jewel, then you run the risk of breaking the jewel. That's the best anvil we can select. Three anvils with the set, it's lacking. You can buy the Horia anvils, they fit. I have already set the micrometer. Now when you pull the lever, it's been set that it stops when the pusher touches the jewel. You need to remember the position, because when you push the new jewel back in, you want to be in the exact position so it stops right there and the jewel is in the same position where it was before. Note it reads from right to left, it looks like 75, but it actually is 65. The thing with lever style jeweling tools, you have to hold the lever. As soon as you let go, the spindle moves up and the plate is not held anymore. So you set the micrometer to the position where the pusher touches the jewel, and if you look here, this is where it will stop and you can't push any further. That's what you want when you're pushing a jewel in. If you need to adjust the end shake, let's say you need to reduce it by 0.02 mm, you turn the micrometer from 65 down to 63, you put the plate on the anvil, push the lever until it stops, and that would move the jewel down the whole 0.02 mm. To push the jewel out, you'd lower the micrometer slightly, not too little, not too much, just so the pusher stops somewhere here. If you overdo it, then as you pull on the lever and the jewel pops out, you'll hit the plate with the pusher. Not a good idea. Alternatively, when you have it set in the position where the pusher makes contact with the jewel, you could push the lever, hold it and turn the micrometer, slowly pushing the jewel out. But there's a lot of friction there, it's not been designed for that, it's not ideal. There is a lot of friction there anyway. I've never been happy with this tool how difficult it is to turn the micrometer. I think it's the two posts here. We should have a look at what's going on. Let's investigate. This one looks okay, but this one, see, it's on an angle. I should have looked at it a long time ago. I never did because I bought the Horia tool shortly after this one, but at least we'll get to see it in parts. And here's our problem. That's where the friction is. The pin on the left is not too bad, but the one on the right is a mess. Cheaply made, sold for a lot of money. We might as well have a look inside while we're here. I'll clean the threads and I'll clean the threads on the micrometer too. Hopefully the action will be somewhat smoother. And while we're here, this is how the tightening works. You can't over tighten it, it stops just there. When you loosen it, it doesn't go back, it's the micrometer that will push it back. I'll put some grease here on both pins and hope for the best. I'm not really that concerned, I only use it as a reamer these days. Apologies, I got a little sidetracked with this, so let's get on with it and let's push the center jewel out. I set the micrometer so it doesn't hit the plate. That's it. Now I've set the micrometer to where it was before I pushed the jewel out. The jewel should be nice and straight there, but it's a little tricky when you're recording it. Now let's give it a push. I like to turn it sometimes just to make sure it's all as equal as possible. That's it, the jewel is back in. Now the Horia tool, same jewel, 1.3 pusher. Threaded action instead of the lever. The plate is in the tool and my hands are free. I like that. Now I can slowly push it down. It doesn't suddenly give like it does with the lever style tools. It's gradual. And to push the jewel back in, I slowly turn the micrometer until the jewel is where I want it to be. Rather than watching the micrometer, taking a note where it was before pushing the jewel out, I observe the jewel instead as I'm pushing it in. Then I test the end shake and adjust it if I need to. You can do either, it's your choice. You'd still need to test the end shake even if you go by the micrometer. I think that's about right, it will have to be tested no matter what. You could use the Bergeon tool like the Horia tool, sort of. It's not perfect. You can use the micrometric cup. The problem with that, the spindle will go down, but it will not go up. The spindle screws on this cup on the threads here, but the cup here, the spindle doesn't attach to the cup. When the spindle is attached to the cap, the spring will push on the cap and will push it up, and that can happen with the micrometric cap. The way it works, you put the spindle in and you screw this cap on. Now you can rotate it just like you would do with the Horia tool, and the spindle will go slowly down. The threads are not as nice as the Horia tool, but you have the same control. When you're done, you unscrew it like the Horia, but the spindle will not move. I'm using my finger here just for the demonstration, but of course tweezers would be the tool to use. It's not perfect, but it works. The Horia tool, that's nice and simple. You move it down, and you move it up. Looking in the old Seitz brochure, they used to make a tool that looks like it worked like the Horia does. It even has the smaller diameter section here like the Horia. Whether it worked the same way, I don't know. I've never seen one. Now, Incabloc. It's this one here. Let's have a look at it. If I zoom on it, we can see it from the top here. And this is the underside of it. I'll be using the Horia tool and set because that's what I have. There is another set on the market, but whether it's as nice as the Horia, I don't know. It works exactly the same way as jewels. Find the right pusher, find the right anvil, and treat it like a jewel. That was nice and easy. The anvils don't have holes in them, you'll find the Incabloc in the anvil. And as you can see, unlike the jewels, you will need a different size pusher to get it back in. The top side is larger. After you've found the appropriate pusher and anvil, same again, just like a jewel. There's a little bit more guiding here without the centering pins, but it's easy enough. That was straightforward. With the Bergeon set, we get a pusher and an anvil for tightening cannon pinions. Cannon pinions usually have an indent on them, it's on the tube right here. That's where the cannon pinion needs to be squeezed. The blade of the pusher needs to go into that indent. Just like you see it here, the blades have to be parallel. It can be a little tricky to place it between the blades. You could put a brooch or something through the cannon pinion to help you to guide it. Once the micrometer is set, where it makes contact with the cannon pinion, the way I would do it, I'd move the cannon pinion out of the way, lower the micrometer slightly. Me personally, I'd do this in very small steps, then place the cannon pinion back between the blades and give it a squeeze. Then the cannon pinion would have to go on the center wheel and it would need to be tested. I would do small, gradual steps until I'm happy that it fits just right. We also get four pushers for reducing our hand tubes with the Bergeon set. The tube fits in the pusher. We'd place it on the anvil, give it a squeeze, and the diameter would be reduced. If you don't have these pushers with your jewel inset, you could probably find stakes in a stake inset that would do the job. Bergeon also gives us the option to reduce the diameter of holes in plates. Here I have 1.39 reamer that just goes through the hole. This pusher fits perfectly and definitely needs an anvil with a hole to accommodate for the tip of the pusher. This one fits perfectly. If we selected an anvil one size up, see this one is a larger one, it's not the one you just saw, it's just here. We'd be flexing the plate and that would have less impact on reducing the hole, if any. This is the right size anvil, you can see it doesn't protrude here. Now we basically squeeze the plate, reducing the diameter of the hole. And we'll do it from the other side too. Now the 1.39 reamer won't go through, so the hole has been reduced. This is more commonly done with stake insets. The stake insets will have more rounded punches than the four pushers you get with the jewel inset, and if the stakes don't fit, the anvils from jewel insets can be used instead. Both tools are suitable, both will do the job. Here I have a scan from the old Seitz brochure. If you look at the pusher, that corresponds to the pushers in the Bergeon set. But if you look at the drawing, This one is rounded, just like the punches from the steak inset. The rounded one is less likely to protrude through the plate. It's nice to have both, you have more options. These are reamers, we also get them with the Bergeon set. We have to remove the lever, we have to remove the spindle for jeweling, and we also have to remove this knot that's for guiding the jeweling spindle. Now it's free for the reamer. We can't place this plate directly on the table, we'll have to use an anvil, and the 1.99 fits in the anvil just fine. We're going to ream out the hole that we just reduced, up to 1.99mm. This has to be done step by step, reamer by reamer. This is not done with force. If you want to see this in detail, I have done a video where I reamed out a hole and used a custom made jewel to fit the reamed out hole. I'll leave the link in the description. This video is not how to, it's to show you what these two tools can do and how they differ. I recorded the whole process for this video, reamer by reamer, but it is long as it is, so I'll skip to the last one, the 1.99, I'll speed it up a little and we'll have a look at the result after. So this is what we started with, and this is what we have now. It would need tidying up. I'm not going to go into that in this video. Check out the video I mentioned, it's in the description. Here's a scan from the Seitz brochure. If you're interested, you can pause it and read it. We also have the option to adjust the pallet stuff with both sets. This is the Bergeon set, but I'm going to use the Horia set, and I'm going to use it because the pallet stuff is delicate, and the Horia gives me much better control than the Bergeon. And also the pusher and the anvil are much nicer. This pallet fork, the stuff could only be pushed one way. But this one, you could push it either way. They are small, very small. I'm going to choose the smallest one on the right, it's the one that can be adjusted either way. These pushers are not designed for removing the stuff. They are for adjusting the stuff. You can't fully push them out. I'm going to push the stuff out just for the purpose of this video to show you how the tool can be used to insert a new pallet stuff. I know I could break the pivot, but this video is about what these tools are capable of. Besides that, if you were removing a stuff, you'd most likely be doing it because you already have a broken pivot. And here we go, all in one piece. I had to surround the anvil with Rodicol to be able to keep the pallet fork in place while trying to insert the stuff in. It's tricky when it's this small. Let me move the Rodicol out of the way a little, just so you can see it better. I'll push it in and I'll go further than where it was before, so we can flip it on the other side and see the adjusting. It would need a few adjustments until it's right, but I think it should be clear how these tools are used. We should have a look at the Bergeon pushers and anvils. That's the Bergeon pusher and anvil, but they are in the Horia tool. I don't get the control with the lever, so I choose the Horia tool. The diameter of the anvil could be an issue. See how close it is to the shellac? A pallet fork attached smaller than this one, and you wouldn't be able to use it. I'm back where I was, Bergeon pusher, Horia anvil, Horia tool. And the pusher works just fine, no problem adjusting it, but if you have a small pallet fork, you could have an issue with the diameter of the anvil. Let's have a look at the guard pin pusher and anvil and how to use it. We have two different examples of guard pins here. This one, it's one piece. It's not adjustable. But this one, if you look carefully, You'll see how the pin goes through the pallet fork. The pin is a separate piece. I was going to use this fork until I looked at the pin from the other side and noticed it was sealed. So I went hunting on eBay and found this pallet fork. It's obvious that this one has been replaced. It looks like a homemade pin. Not a pretty pin, but perfect for this video to show you how it works. And that's our tools. That's what the pusher looks like. It needs to be aligned with the anvil like this. I'm going to show you now how it works. This is like a surgery. The pin is so small. Make sense now? The guard pin is in the hole of the pusher, and the flat side of the pusher is there to have some clearance between the pusher and horns of the pallet fork. You would push the pallet fork on the pin. To groove in the anvil, you should be able to see that's there for the pallet stuff. However, we can't remove the pin. If we turn it over 180 degrees to push from the other side, the pusher is in the way of the stuff. The pusher would need to be similar to the anvil. One pusher that will insert and remove the guard pins. It's doable. I have contacted Horia about it and they see it as a possible improvement. It's gone to their technical office. If they ever make it, there will be a link to it in the description and I will probably make a short to show it in action. I should also mention uprighting in this video. There is nothing in the instructions that came with the Bergeon tool regarding to uprighting. What you are looking at here is a scan from the old Seitz brochure. If you look carefully at the drawing, what they call a pump here is something we don't get with the new Bergeon sets. It's nothing like the pushers we get with this set. The pump doesn't go above the table of the tool, it's actually below. If you look at the pushers we get, this is how they sit in the tool. They wobble and they have a narrow section here. So back to this drawing, the pump here is shorter and the shape is simple. It's a completely different thing to the pushers we get with the modern sets, and we don't get this pump. So unfortunately, I can only mention uprighting, but I can't show you because I don't have the means. Now listen carefully, this is very important if you want to save some money and own very fine tools. And to do that, we have to visit Horia website. Shocking, I know, but let me show you. And stick with it, I'm going to show you a number of things that may surprise you. The prices are in Swiss francs, you will have to do your own maths to work out how much it will cost you. Just Google Swiss franc to GBP, USD or whatever your currency is. I am in the UK and from my experience, the suppliers I buy from, their prices don't include VAT, which is 20% in the UK. Horia, the price you see is the price you pay. You may have to pay import duty and that will vary from country to country, so you will have to work that one out for yourself. We're looking at the set of pushers I bought directly from Horia. With the added delivery and import duty, I ended up paying around £970. The cheapest I can find these pushers in the UK is for £1,000 and that does not include 20% VAT. That's over £200 difference. Same for the smaller sets, same for the tool itself, Incabloc pushers and so on. It's cheaper directly from Horia. Let's be honest, these tools are not cheap, Horia or Bergeon, but the way I see it, you get a better deal from Horia. The new redesigned Bergeon dueling tool will set you back in the UK £1,800. Now if you look at this one, forget that price, forget that box, add them individually without the box, 1,758 Swiss francs. That's £1,930 and that's with import duty. You get two tools, enough pushers to start you with, six anvils, and you get Reamers too. Okay, it's slightly more expensive than the Bergeon, but not a great deal and the quality of the pushers and anvils makes up for it. And the control you get with the Horia tool for adjusting end shakes is just something else. Yes, you don't get the Canon pinion bits, hole reducing pushers, hour hand tube pushers, but they fit the Horia tool should you need them. They are not expensive. You might pay slightly more for the Horia, but you get so much more for your money. And don't forget Horia makes pushers and anvils that are not even in the set of 24 I have. And if that's not good enough, they make you one to your specification. It's not just pushers and anvils. If you need a tool that doesn't exist, Horia are the people who can make it for you. But let's talk about tools rather than pushers. As you know, I use the Bergeon tool only for reaming, and you do need a reamer. So you'd think you need the lever style tool to have a reamer. I'm not so sure you need that tool. What everyone does need is a stake inset. You can't be without one. And from what I can see, you can use the Horia stake inset as a reamer. The spindle for reaming that comes with the dual inset is under accessories for the stake insets. I own this stake inset. I bought it before the price went up, but now it will cost you around £2,000. If you end up like me, and I know many of you have, and use the Seitz only as a reamer, you end up with a very expensive reamer. If I could turn the clock back, instead of the stake inset and the lever style dueling tool, I'd buy this complete set, I'd add the spindle and reamers and still save hundreds of pounds. Horia is well known for their craftsmanship and I'd probably have a very fine tool. However, the problem is we don't know, well, I don't know that much about the Horia stake inset. I've never seen a video, I googled it and I couldn't find anything, and that leaves the question, will it do everything I need it to do? It's certainly different. Instead of long punches, we get short staking hammers. They will attach to a spindle. There is only one hole in the table. Where's the rest? I think that's where you put the short staking hammers. Kind of like an inverto, and you also get 3 drill anvils and 3 full anvils. There are more bits there you don't get with the usual stake insets, and I don't even know what they are used for. Rod weight? Chucks? Here we have a table with various holes. I am curious about their stake inset. It looks interesting, it's intriguing. And there are other tools. This handsetting tool will these days, in early 2024, cost you around £1,050. If you look at this tool, that will cost you around £760. You can get a lot more accessories and pushers, and the accessories are considerably cheaper. So why did I buy the Bergeon? Unfortunately, I wasn't looking here. You should check Horia website out, you could save a lot of money. I'll leave a link to their website in the description. Guys, nothing against Bergeon, I have plenty of their tools and no doubt I will end up with more. There are some very nice Bergeon tools I would love to own and I might show you one day if I get them. They are generally fine and I have no issues for most part, but from my experience, they cannot compete with Horia. You've seen the pushes at the start of the video. Horia is in a different league. And the action of the tool, the control it gives me, is so much nicer than the lever style tool. I know many of you use the lever style, have been using it for decades, and that's what you used to and like. Each to their own. At the end of the day, whichever tool works for you is the best tool. I hope I gave you some insight if you're thinking of buying a dueling tool. This is my opinion, my experience, so I highly suggest you do more research and see what others have to say about the Horia and the Bergeon before you spend your money. For me, it's the Horia, all the way. But you, not me, you have to make your own decision. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give it a like. More people will get to see this video if you do. I don't produce videos very often. If you don't want to miss them, enable the notifications. And if you think this video was worth it, I have a Buy Me A Coffee link in the description or the YouTube Super Thanks. Bye for now.